My friends, I would like now to show you a classical trick of magic. It's one of the oldest tricks in magic. It's called the cups and balls. Like, oh, you already seen verses, are you? Oh, that's good. This one, it involves two little balls. They're both exactly the same. Especially this one. And two metal cups. Good, strong, solid metal. Although this one can go through this one and this one can go through that one, but that's not important. These cups are only meant for covering the balls. Because if I cover the balls like that, I cannot touch them anymore. Well, because the metal, it prevents me to do that, no? There's a cup over it, you can't touch it. Unless you take it through the tops of the cup, but that's the weak part. Okay. I'll show you how a little ball can come underneath this cup. Here we go. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was... I'll show you one more time. Yep, that's better. Anyway, you know, sometimes people ask me, is it possible to possible? Possible to pass a ball. And, if you just do... you've got it there. And here, of course, there is nothing left. I should find some better glue for this one day. Yeah, let's continue. There's two little balls here. Now, I would like you to point to one of them. That one or that one, whichever. That one? Okay, hold it on your hand, like this. Take it, yep, like this. I will cover it with this cup so that I cannot touch it, yes? Now you tell me when you feel it leave. Did you feel it leave? Uh-uh. No? But... Oh, you got the feeling. Oh. I'll show you how both of them can go through the cup together. Here they go, both of them together. You know why they don't go? The cup is already full. Yeah, that was you. Oh, yeah. I know you. I just want to sneak around him, huh? All right. Thank you.